Welcome back to the Shanglao Sports Center Stadium in Chengdu, one of the biggest expansion towns in China, for the day two program of the athletics here at the World University Games.
And of course, we're going to be moving around here, so the women's long jump is about to start. And this is Haraska, the leader of the event so far from the first jump. And that's long. That is long. That's by far the longest jump of the evening so far. She looks as though she's a little spaced out. Good speed. Fantastic takeoff position on that left foot. Great conversion from the horizontal to the vertical. She reaches up, look, that head, but stays up, focused, looking ahead. And it takes her into the pit. She's jumping up and down. We're just waiting for that distance to come. 6 meters 60. And she substantiates her position at the top of the leaderboard. And the long jump starts to hot up. This is Boken coming up and lining up for her fifth round jump. 6:25. Put her back up the leaderboard in that fourth round. But this is her fifth attempt in this long jump final. Oh, that's a good jump. That's better from Boken. So Magdalena Boken of Poland looks as though she's improved on that 6:25, warming up nicely as this long jump competition comes towards the final rounds. This is the fifth round jump for the pole. And I think she's happy. Yes, 6:41 for Boken, and she goes into silver medal position. This long jump has taken a long time to get to the boil. And this young lady was eighth at the end of the first three rounds. She's jumped up the leaderboard now because of that 6 meters, 6:24 jump in the third round. And this is her final jump in this long jump competition. And that's good. That's 6 meters plus for Bhagavathy of India. Left foot plants, good height off the board. And it looks like her hair, her ponytail hair, has gone back into the sand, further back than her heels and body went into the sand. We're just waiting for that distance to come up. 6 meters 32, and she now has gone from eighth position after the third round into the bronze medal position. Boken of Poland, who was down in sixth position into the last three rounds, jumped 6:41 in that fifth round, moved up to silver, and you can see that gold, silver, and bronze were handed out. And the bronze medal was literally grabbed by Bhagavathy of India on her last jump. And down the other end of the stadium, we have the men's discus throw getting ready to commence. Oskar Stachnic of Poland. Poland have fantastic heritage in the throwing events, particularly the hammer and the shot. And this man is one of their best discus throwers. 62-69, season's best, but has thrown over 64 meters. He's whipped that out. Great flight on that discus. And over the 60 meter line for the pole here. So first round, wide stance at the back of the circle, works around that left foot, active reverse into the delivery phase, he's actually got a fixed front foot there. And 62-53 puts him into the lead in the early stages of the discus men's final. Chang of Jamaica, 61-66 in that first round. He resides currently after the first round, his second position. Long arms, good reach, wide stance at the back, a big man. Active reverse, spins around that front foot, launches the discus over 60 meters again. So Chang being very consistent here, the Jamaican. 61-66 on that first attempt. You can see that blocking leg, that left leg, touches the surface and then actively goes backwards to allow the hip to strike. 61-82 for Chang on his second round throw. And here we have, coming into the circle for his fifth round, the Algerian recent record holder, broke the record earlier this season. And he's coming in for his fifth round attempt. He'll be looking to get over 60 metres, just shy of that so far. Very fast across the circle for a big man. Better flight on that discus. Yes, sails past the 60 metre line. In that fifth round, he went, just under 59 metres and celebrating far more than that. But I think he's going to find out that now we see the celebration. That's a new national record. He moves into third place, into the medals for the big Algerian. Great throwing by him, 61 metres, 33. And to wrap up this fifth round, he's the Polish leader. He's led from round one with 62.53. Stachnik of Poland into the circle for his fifth round throw. Very fast, great placement of that right foot to strike the ground, and that's comfortably over the 60 metre line, closer to 63. Look at this, splits the circle, rotates round that blocking left foot for that split second, is there, strikes with his hip from the floor for that right foot. And yep, look at that, what a sequence, 63 metres. And the 25-year-old Pole, just below his personal best, but you can see here. Now, Ganusi had the best of 61.78, a new record that I've checked out, so it wasn't a new record by the Algerian. He was in fifth place going into that last round, but pushed the Italian Manucci into fourth place. And I'll hand you over to Angus for the start of this 10,000 metres.
Off we go then, the final of the men's 10,000 metres. A battle between South Africa, Uganda, Morocco and China. China winning last night with Xi. And a little bit of a push here. This is the first real burst here. Now bursting. I can see the way they're going single file. Well, this is an early one. There's a little bit of wind in the stadium. It's just got slightly cooler, and maybe they've reacted to that drop in temperature. They're feeling good at the front. Yako, off he goes, dragging his teammate with him. Atuk, one of the Turks, has decided he can't afford to let them get away. Dismas Yako, looking to become the third Ugandan winner of this title since 2005. He's just 18 years old. What a talent is coming through once more from the Indaiat University, the reigning cross-country champion.
The South African Chris Malanga looks like he's beginning to struggle. So then, we are down to four. We are past halfway. Things have got quicker. Looks like we're going to negative split this quite comfortably.
This is fascinating, what's going on in the 10,000 metres. Cheptegor has been dropped now. He got dropped with about 6.5 laps to go. They were going past one of the Ugandans, lapping him, and Yako has latched on to Akampa. And Akampa is trying to help his teammate. And they are both trying to go after attack. They tried to go through him as you were watching the discus there. They couldn't do it. Attack managed to stay in front. And there's a red card coming out. I think that is for the Ugandan Akampa, because you're not allowed to wait for the teammate to come round and then join in the race once more. Well, there were echoes of Roger Bannister there in the first ever mile record underneath 4 minutes, when it was legal to do, although it was certainly controversial. This time, though, not controversial, and the red flag comes out, and we're not even in a walk. So then, it means that Dimas is on his own again. Attack and Dimas. Yamamoto around about 30 metres now down on them. He looks as though he's fairly safe in the bronze medal position, because Cheptegor, the Kenyan, is another 40 metres behind him. And Sejin Atak from the Dikil University in Turkey, the 25-year-old. Crowd trying to get behind their own men, but they are a long way out of it. They're not going to be the same glory that we saw last night in the women's 10,000 metres. Dimas goes in front for the first time in around about 10 laps. And he's making a real drive for home inside the last mile. Attack trying to stay with him now, having been in front. They're coming up to one of the Chinese tail enders. Counting down even more. This is fascinating. Oh, and Dimas comes in again. An attack looks like he will be going into defence. He'll be looking after the silver medal. Dimas goes through. 1,200 metres to go. And Uganda look like they're on course for a third gold medal in the men's 10,000 metres since 2005. And he looks very, very comfortable indeed. I think he's just watching himself. Because at the moment, Attack, you can see, is gasping for oxygen behind him. So again, the Turks are going to be disappointed. Silver and bronze last night. And it looks like they're going to have to settle for silver this evening. Here he comes. The 18-year-old. From the Ndebs University. And after Ugandan wins in 2005 and 2017, it's Dimas Yego who becomes the 2023 World University Games champion. 2 years after it was supposed to happen, he crosses the line first. Attack takes another silver medal for Turkey in second place. And behind him, Yamamoto will come across to take the bronze medal for Japan. But this race is all about the teenager from Uganda. A little shake of the hand from Yamamoto, who looks at him and goes, who are you? It's a fabulous win for Dimas Yego. So confirmation there of Dimas Yego's glorious victory at the age of just 18 of the men's 10,000 metres title at the World University Games, ahead of Sinjin Attack, who got the silver medal, and Yamamoto of Japan, who took the bronze.
Congratulations to all the medalists.
And now we're back to the action in the field with the men's shot put. Next into the circle, Simon Mazur of Poland, who snuck into and took that silver medal position behind his colleague and comrade Musawiki, who's the reigning champion. So rotates around, stands up, just puts that left shoulder down, but it's out over 18 meters for the Pole, who's second string in this event behind the reigning champion from Naples, who set that world, that Universiade record, FISU record in Naples at 21 meters 54. He's not in that form, we have to say, at this moment in time. 19 meters 20, he cements his position in the silver possession. This is the reigning champion, the man who studies at the police academy in Poland. This is his third Universiade. What can he do in this round? Well, there you go. His first throw over 20 meters seemed to fall away a little bit. It went down the right hand side of the sector, so he's not quite firing on all cylinders. But a big man in a big event, and he goes over 20 meters, but nowhere near that record he set in Naples in 2019 on the 8th of July 2023. But it was 21 meters 54 in Naples. And we're going to visit the shot circle for the sixth and final round. This is the left-hander, Bastenrath, and he's gone over 18 metres. Now, he's currently, we saw the graphic, was lying back in fourth position. May have actually even been fifth into this last round. Very tidy, very athletic. Pops it out to the left-hand side of the sector. Look, like you really ideally want to put it, but 18.69, and he snuck into the bronze medal position. So Konrad Bugawiczy takes his second gold medal in the FISU Championships with his teammate Mazur in Silva and Hasenrath jumping up from fifth position to third position in the final round with his sixth attempt at 1869, and he tags and he bags that bronze medal and takes it away from the two Chinese putters who finished in fourth and fifth position.
So here we go then, the women's 100 metres final. This is an event that has had a number of champions from different countries, from the likes of Finland and Lithuania, Kazakhstan, of course the Americans and the Jamaicans, but it was a historic win for India last time out with Dute Chand. So there is the lineup from Australia, Brazil, Luxembourg, China, Austria, Slovakia, Germany and Poland. The crowd already are making a lot of noise away to my left-hand side. Patricia van der Wieken, 11.24 in the semi-finals, easily the quickest, with all eyes on Liang. Fourth fastest in the semis, 11.43, qualified by Wright. So then Geddes in two, Debassy in three, van der Wieken in four, Liang in five, Lindner 6, Forster in 7, Preppens in 8, Ramasco in 9, the final of the women's 100 metres at the 2023 World University Games. Who will get the best start? A blanket start. Liang, though, has got out really well, and she's got a half a metre lead. Here comes van der Wieken. Van der Wieken's long legs coming through. Van der Wieken coming to cross the line to take gold! Gold for Luxembourg! Silver for Victoria Forster of Slovakia! And I think Liang may have held on for bronze, but we'll need to see the pictures. Van der Wieken, 11.22, 2 tenths outside her personal best, but does she care? No! It's a first global title for the woman from Luxembourg. And they will be celebrating as well in the Lunex University in Overcorn, near to the French border. Lindner has come through to take the bronze medal, 11.44. Liang ran out of it. A new personal best for Sam Geddes in form, but she misses out on bronze by 0.02. Liang misses out on the podium by 0.04. It was a tight finish there at the end. But van der Wieken shows that she can live with the pressure. A quiet start in the heat. She made her intent known in the semis. Liang got off to a firebolt start. Wonderful run by Forster. She's only 21, remember, but look at that finish to take her past three women. But van der Wieken was just too far ahead. And you can see the fluidity in the semi-finals from Liang disappeared in the final as the pressure told. Brilliant finish, lunge from Magdalena Lindner. And the two friends who embraced in the semi-finals have managed to get medals in the final. Brilliant run, brilliant race. Commanding. Van der Wieken will take so much confidence from that. She's almost on the cusp of breaking through into sub 11 second territory. Maybe a little bit of the experience here will send her on her way. 11.22, clear victory for Patricia van der Wieken, becomes the first Luxembourger to win a gold here at the World University Games. Forster in second and Lindner in third. One more event on the track tonight on day two. It's the men's 100 metres. 2 years ago, or 4 years ago, this heralded a magnificent double for Paulo André Camilo of Brazil. So then Goldson and Masanguanyi next to each other. So then Chen in two of China. Suda Poland in three, Goldson Jamaica four,
Maswanganyi of South Africa in 5, Lin of Chinese Taipei in 6, Deng China 7, Ozer Turkey in 8, and on the outside, Fruen of Germany in lane 9. This could be a cracker. Good start away first time, and Maswanganyi's got away well, but Goldson is on his shoulder. Maswanganyi is on the shoulder though. The front two come together, and it's going to be the Jamaican who takes it. 10-0-2. Kadrian Goldson wins the gold. Maswanganyi of South Africa the silver. And the man who was the quickest in the semis is the fastest in the final. And Jamaica get their first champion since Shaq Harvey, who won it in Shenzhen the last time that the World University Games were on Chinese soil in Shenzhen. 10-0-2 has been downgraded to 10-0-4 again. He replicates what he did in the semis. And Chen has taken the gold bronze medal for China. Cheer goes around. It might not be gold, but perhaps that was never really on the cards. That is a victory, really, for Chen. The best of the rest. The two men who have both gone under 10 seconds. A meter better than everybody else. And so South Africa's wait to see whether or not they could get another champion after Anaso Jobanwana in 2017. And Akane Simbine in 2015. But instead, it's silver again for South Africa for the third year in a row, or the third games in a row, after Thando Roto and Chedric Van Wyk in 2017 and 2019. Well, Goldson again didn't get the best start, but he had the best finish. Maswanganyi trying not to think about the man on his left-hand side. Well, Deng is there to look with Chen. I think that was just before they knew that Chen had got the bronze medal. Just another day at the office, it seems, for Goldson. Perhaps disappointed that he didn't get that championship record, which he is easily capable of doing. So then Kadrian Goldson wins in 10-0-4, 200ths of a second ahead of Maswanganyi of South Africa, with Chen of China beating Lin of Chinese Taipei to that bronze medal.